The following is a presentation of TFNN. Trade What You See with Larry Pesavento. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648 or internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Larry Pesavento.
Okay, looking good, Billy Ray. Feeling good, Lewis. Well, we have some exciting things going on today. Boys and girls, the Treasury bonds and Treasury notes are breaking down rapidly. We've been suggesting that over the last few days because we only had a 38% retracement in these, and now we've started to accelerate to the downside. I can't imagine why the Federal Reserve would be raising rates into this election, given the fact that Ms. Yellen is a Democrat and that the campaign person from the Republican side has spoken so harshly about her. I just don't understand that, but you never know what they're going to do. But the rates are going higher. You can see that in the German bond. You can see it in the Treasury notes and the Treasury bonds, and they're accelerating. That's another thing that's going on. I believe we have Hema Reddy on the line this morning. Hema, are you there?
Yes, can you hear me?
Yes, we certainly can. Now, I had to cut you off quickly yesterday because we were ending the show, and you were going to offer a free example of your newsletter and stuff.
Yes, thanks for having me back to share that. I did get a few of you contact me and sign up for the newsletter. Appreciate that. A few folks also went for the free chart of the week. But in my second phase of reviving this newsletter, I have it going until basically the end of October, October 27th. And the rest of this week, if you email me at hema@hemaready.com with the subject line Larry TFNN, got to give credit where it's due, then I will add you on to my paid newsletter free for the rest of this week. And that may not sound like a lot, you know, 3-4 days of a newsletter, but I really look closely intraday at the E-mini every morning, and I think it's a great way to see if this type of analysis and education is something you want. So again, just send an email to hema@hemaready.com, subject Larry TFNN, and I'll add you to the list. You'll just have to confirm the subscription to keep getting it. And then if you want to stay on through the end of the month, the fee is only $15, and I'm just accepting that via PayPal right now. So free for the rest of this week, $15 if you want it till the end of the month. And I'm here if you have any questions by email anytime.
Well, listen, thank you very much, and we'll have you on again in the future. How's that?
Sounds good. And, you know, we don't need to go through it now. I have your show lined up, but I did send you, Larry, today's chart of the E-mini in case, you know, the topic comes up and you want to put it up. It's in a PDF in your inbox.
Sure. I can put that up at the break. I'll be happy to do that for you.
Okay, great. Thanks a lot.
Okay. All right. That's Hema Reddy from the skinny and the E-mini. And so we'll show that chart just a little bit later. Folks, let's get to talking about the main thing that's going on here. Yesterday, we were looking at that British pound holding that 128.40 level. It stayed there all day. It had several 30 or 40 point rallies. And as we said, if it went below 128, it was in really bad shape. And as soon as we broke 128, if you have an interest in foreign exchange, you'll see that it immediately dropped like a rock, you know, about 80 pips straight down, telling you that we're looking at something, you know, a lot more serious. Yes, bye-bye British pound. It's not bye-bye British pound. Folks, the old low was way back in February of 1985 when we had the Plaza Accord. The pound was trading at 85. And, you know, now we're trading at, 127. If we take a look at the work of our good friend Jim Bartolioni, you'll notice here, this is his long-term chart going back over the past 30 years. You'll see that we've had a really sharp low way back there in 1985, and the market doubled in price after that low was in. And as you can see, we had a couple of nice big ABCD patterns through this. But what we're looking at here is we're breaking below that key support line. We did rally right up into that 135 level that Jim suggested. That was a 382 retracement. We did that about 3.5 weeks ago, and now we're starting to come down. The question mark over there on the right is, how low are we going to go? And that's the $64 question, you know, to look at. The U.S. dollar is still strengthening. We can see that in the weakness in the euro, and we'll watch that as we go through some of these things. The question someone's just asked, can you see 122 in the British pound? That would be very easy to do because just from where we were on Friday, we've dropped almost 400 pips. So another 400 pips takes us, really close to that level. Well, 500 pips takes you exactly to 122. The problem that we have here is that once we break through the 1.618 to the downside, we really don't have anything, you know, to use as a pattern. In other words, you'd have to go down to a much smaller pattern in order to find something. And frankly, there is, there's nothing there to show you that this is actually, you know, going to do anything other than to keep going lower. That's what it looks like. There doesn't seem to be anything as far as any support coming in here at all. Now, yesterday, oh, by the way, very important announcement, folks. Don't miss tomorrow's show. We're going to have one of our favorite folks on, Bill Meridian from Cycles Research of Vienna, Austria, and we're going to have him on for almost the whole show. I'm going to be on the first 10 minutes, and then the rest of the show we're going to be letting Bill take over and show us some of his incredible cycle work. He's also going to be talking to us a little bit about the astrological charts of our two candidates and what that might look like, coming into the election. And certainly we've never had an election like this, not in the eight decades that I've been on this planet. We've never seen anything like that. So hopefully, it's getting to be a little bit embarrassing when I get emails from people from, emails from Spain and Denmark and the United Kingdom today, complaining about how we act here in the United States. And what am I supposed to say? I said, yeah, you're right. It's not very good. All right, let's look at this gold because we were expecting this gold to come down here, and we're breaking now. We're almost down to a really key figure, and that's 1288. And 1288 is the 78% retracement of the low that we made back in June, the middle of June, and it's also a 50% retracement of the low from early June. So 1288 should give us some pretty, what I would think, substantial report. Now, yesterday we were talking about silver. Yes, you're right. The Europeans are laughing at us. We think Brexit was a bad deal. I mean, compared to what we have going on in the news. And the news is, you just can't believe anything anymore. All right, let's get to the stuff that's important here. Let's take a look here. We've already exceeded our levels in silver. Let me just show you where we are because we are at one of those magical numbers at 1850 in the in Christmas silver. You'll notice the little red box there. That's the ABCD pattern, two of them, and also a 1.618 expansion. 877-927-6648.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS
has proprietary algorithms, this feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com. Larry takes your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Okay, folks, we're going to take a look at that gold chart. I've blown it up a little bit. Got rid of the stuff on the left that's, you know, happened in far, far past. But what we're looking at, currently, as you can see, the ABCD patterns that are forming. We had the 135 pattern that it was indicative that we most probably were in a bear market, and that's certainly what's happened now. What we're doing now is we're coming down into some pretty strong support that comes in at around 1282, I believe, in the Christmas gold. That's a 78% retracement off of the low we made in mid-June. And it's also a 50% retracement of the low we made in late May. That's where those numbers come from. Now, you could, I think the easiest one to look at, because silver and gold trade so closely together, the low in silver at, watch this low in silver. It's going to be really important if we get there. We're trading at 1858 right now in silver. And about 1851, in other words, if we would go down and make another new low by just a little penny or so, that would be an exact 1.618 retracement of that whole move. And that's one of those times where you would be able to buy silver and not risk very much. I mean, this is not a buy recommendation, folks. I'm just saying this is where someone that watches the tape would be looking to go long around that 1851 level in the silver. You could also look at the gold to see what it's doing at that time, but these are the things that we're watching. Someone's asked me the question of how all this relates, you know, to the Treasury bonds and the U.S. and the U.S. markets and the U.S. dollar and stuff. Folks, all I do is I just look at the patterns of the charts that I'm looking at. That's what I really understand. The underlying economics of supply and demand and the news that's out there is so far over my pay grade that I don't even try to understand it, because I've seen situations where Gold should go absolutely to the moon. And what does it do? It totally collapses. And I've seen, you know, I've seen everything, you know, been there, done that. So all I focus on is what the patterns are doing. That's the sum total of all the buyers and sellers in that market. And that's what gives me the edge that I can see. And I know that these patterns, you know, work a lot more than they fail. And I also know what the number sequences are of the Fibonacci summation sequence. And so that gives me, you know, another edge. And so that's another thing that I have in order to keep my sanity. And, you know, that's really what I try to do. I mean, it's not much more difficult than that. And I have a couple of degrees, advanced degrees in economics. And I still don't understand it, you know, especially nowadays with the, you know, quantitative easing and stuff that goes on. So, and when you bring in the astrology part, I know a very small portion of that, you know, and all I try to do is look at some of the key dates in the astrology. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't, just like in the Bradley model, but it all gets down to probabilities. That's really what you're looking at. Now, the next chart that I wanted to put into Tiger TV today is the one from Hema Reddy. You'll see here that we had a really nice chart that she sent. It gives her her email address, as you can see right on the chart itself, so that if you want to try the service for a few days, you'll get a pretty good idea of you know what we're looking at. I think the key to watch today is the fact that we've had so much weakness coming in, you know, into the Treasury bonds. And also into the gold market. You know, we're down $20-some now in gold, and it's getting very, very close into this 1280 area. So we want to watch that very, very closely. I've got my limit minder on to tell me if silver gets to that 1850 level, and I want to keep a very close eye on that, because that 1.618 number is really, you know, really very, very powerful. If we go, see, and with the silver, we've broken below all of the ABCD patterns that were there. You know, that's the, you know, the pattern. The first comes the ratio, the second comes the pattern, because the ratios are related to mathematics, and mathematics is what rules the universe, and that's Einstein, had nothing to do with me. But anyway, that's what we want to watch with the both gold and silver here today. And the fact that they're down so much early is a pretty good sign here, because many times these markets, as you know, they get too far down, and then short covering starts to turn, and they can have one heck of a good rally and still be in a bear market. So that's the key to watching some of these things. I wanted to cover a couple of things. You know, we were looking at a few things last week that we didn't quite get to cover everything, and I wanted to show you one. Well, we did this with the soybeans, but I wanted to show you the soybean meal, because it really had a really nice move off of the bottom here. We went from that 1296 area. We rallied about $1,500 in the soybean meal in the first day off of that bottom, which was a 78% retracement, you know, right spot on. And as if you recall, when we were looking at this, we were looking at the soybean contract itself, and also because it was making that very, very important 78% retracement, and we had multiple ABCD patterns down there at the 935 per bushel level, and we've rallied well over $2,000 in the soybeans, and this has caused corn. We were fortunate enough to buy some corn, and it worked okay too. But these are pretty good bottoms in here, and they've come really strong, powerful off of the off of those levels. So as long as that level holds, that we made, you know, late last week, this tells us that we most probably are looking at some type of a rally into the harvest area. Now, one other thing I wanted to mention, just for I don't know if you folks know this or not, but the first week of October, China is basically closed. It is all the markets, the banks are closed. They're everybody's pretty much on vacation, because I think it's called Workers' Week, and that's what I believe, it's something like that. I'll find out from the boss here in a minute, and I will get that answer. But they closed the whole month of October, so they won't be open until Monday. Hong Kong is open, and of course Japan is open, but you know, China is shut down a little bit here. So the stock market, you know, we had a little bit of a sell-off yesterday. It came back pretty good. We're slightly higher today. The market still has a bearish bias to it. And as we get later on into October, the bias starts to increase, you know, even more and more. So you've got to, you know, keep in mind that this can be a real interesting interesting time frame in some of these things. One of the other markets that is starting to really look interesting from the long side that we looked at in the foreign exchange last week was this Japanese yen. When we tested the 135 pattern at the par level, we're now approaching the nearly the 103 level, and that's going to be very, very interesting to see. The, it's called National Day in China is what it's called. So that's it's basically for the workers, and it is really you know, a really big holiday over there. Anyway, let's get on to some of the other things. I don't the Chinese renminbi is going to be included into the SDR special drawing rights, which will be the U.S. dollar index. That'll be on Friday after the close, and we're going to see how much effect it's going to have when that happens. 877-927-6648.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you will lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Okay. Okay, we're back, folks, and we've had a request to take a look at the live cattle. So I've posted the daily live cattle contract. As you can see, we've been in an extended bear market for quite some time. We did have some strong support come in around the 102 level. It lasted for about 2 weeks, and now we're heading down. It looks like we're going to be going to 95 per pound. Folks, we haven't been this cheap in cattle for a very, very long time. So the important thing to look at on this chart, and this is true of all charts, anything that's liquid or actively traded, you're going to be seeing so many of the same similarities that we see, you know, chart after chart, because, you know, the charts are nothing more than the sum total of all the buyers and sellers, which includes the psychology, the supply, demand, everything else. And the good part about being a technical analysis is that they can give you misinformation, they can lie to you, they can cheat you, they can do whatever they want. But the one thing they cannot do, and that is they can't hide from you. If there's more buying, prices go up. If there's more selling, prices go down. Pay particular attention here on this cattle chart, because you'll notice that several months ago we started to have these rallies, and we've had four nearly perfectly equal rallies in cattle. Each one of them would have been a tremendous selling opportunity, which our good friend Rich Anderson was able to spot a few of them, especially at that 114 level, which was a big one. And then, of course, we had the bottom at 102, and we'll have Rich on hopefully later this week. But anyway, you'll notice that you'll see these recurring patterns all the time, and that's what forms these channel lines that you see that leads to things like the Keltner bands or Bollinger bands. And, you know, those are nothing more than standard deviations away from the moving average. But it gives you an idea of a trading range that something is in. And as you can see, we're certainly in a downtrend in cattle with much lower prices, at least 3 or 4 more cents to go to the downside if these ABCD patterns keep completing like they do. Now, sometimes they're going to turn, and you're going to have a bottom. But until that happens, you know, there's no reason to think anything different. Perfect example of that is the gold market. I mean, we're looking for a bottom to come in here in the gold within about between $4 to $10 from where we are right now. That doesn't mean it's going to stop there. It just means it's probably going to have a pretty good rally from that level. So watch that very, very closely. Now, the next one we want to take a look at, we've had a request to talk about the euro because we talked about the U.S. dollar, which I'm going to post in just a minute here. But you'll notice here that the euro yesterday rallied up to a 78% retracement of the high we made back on the 26th of September. And now we've come down and we've tested the 78% level one more time here at this 111.50 level. Folks, if we break below the 111.50 level, we're going to be looking at a very similar situation like we've had in gold and silver. Just let me put this up and you'll see it very easily. We've had these triangles form. You'll notice that we've had a series of lower tops in the euro ever since May. We had a couple of good rallies, you know, rallied off of the Brexit thing. It rallied well over, 500 handles, which is 5,000 dollars. And you'll notice that recently, since the middle of August, we've had these lower highs. That's that 135 pattern that we watch all the time. And now, as you can see from the downside, you know, we're already trading below the lows of just a few days ago, which breaks the that trend line, which is nothing more than a pennant line. A pennant is, you know, when they come together, usually by the time right before the end of the pennant, the market will move, you know, dramatically one way. This is what we had going on in the gold and silver as we came in early in the week, because it had a chance, you know, to hold. But, you know, markets that don't go up go down. So this is what it looks like with the euro. It could still hold this level, and there's very strong support at 111.20, down about 60 pips from where we are now. But below 111.20, there's trouble in River City, folks. Believe me, it's going to be really bad. Hold on 1 second. The beeper is going off, and it is silver. We just hit our level in silver at 18.49. And we're going to hold on. I've got to turn it off, otherwise it'll beep forever. Give me 1 second here. And I, well, there we go. And then all I have to hit is the turn it off. So we're right there. Okay, let's get on to the next one here. The stocks opened a little bit. That looked like the stocks opened about unchanged. You know, not too much happening at this point. So we'll see, you know, what transpires as we go through here. I do want to show you the dollar index, folks, because this is where the real money is. And we've talked about this chart many, many times. And we're at the top end of this chart right now. We're up in the 96 level. This is the one from Friday. But you'll notice that we are going into this same triangle again. If we pop above, you know, should we? Well, it's a long way to get there. If we get above that 98 level, that would take the euro down below, 109 or so. You'd be looking at a really screaming U.S. dollar to the upside. I don't know if that's going to be the case or not, because this is a pretty bearish chart on the U.S. dollar. In other words, we're just, you know, testing these levels again, because after that 5 ratio sequence of numbers that we had back on the 25th of July, you know, we had a perfect 1-3-5 pattern form, and now we're just in this tight trading range. So that's what it looks like to me. We got support in the euro, 111.20, but just a little bit below that. Doesn't give you any hope at all, because it's really going to be, you know, quite a bit of a move to the downside is what it would appear to me. So that's what we're looking at so far early this morning here. And let's just double check what some of the markets are doing. Silver continues to go down. We're now 6 cents below the 1.618 level, so that's not a good thing. And we're very, very close. We're almost into the 1280s in the gold. We're at 1290 and change. So we'll watch this one a little bit closer today also. So these metals are getting banged up pretty good. My assumption is we're probably going to reach a bottom here in the next hour or so in some of these, and we'll have a little bit of a rally, unless they just totally fall out of bed, and we're going to have a, you know, $40 down move in gold, which, you know, we certainly could. We're reaching down here to some pretty interesting levels in the both silver and gold. Of course, I said 1850 in silver was a very important point, and we're at 1844 now, so the market certainly didn't care about that. That was the old low that we made, you know, way back, when was it? Way back here on, way back in middle of September. So we've matched that low. We just took it out by a penny. So that's another one that's going to be really interesting here to see if that's going to hold the case. But we did break below the 1.618 level in the silver, which is certainly not a good sign. That's why, as the markets are dropping like that, you want to wait for it, you know, to see what happens at that point. Because if it doesn't have any support at all, you don't even want to even think about it. And that's exactly what happened here. It just melted right through, just like we did in the British pound yesterday when we looked at that one. So, you know, it's just six and one half dozen the other. You just got to pay your money and take your choice, as they say in Terre Haute, Indiana. 877-927-6648.
If you're looking to discover a new financial resource and diversify your financial portfolio, consider the new Market Safe Focus Commodity CD from EverBank. This 5-year U.S. dollar-denominated CD gives you exposure to 6 equally weighted commodities, including gold, silver, copper, nickel, soybeans, and sugar, in one powerful CD. With annual pricing caps of 50% per component, you could earn up to a 50% upside payment at maturity if the commodities increase in value across annual pricing dates. And should the opposite occur, your principal is 100% protected. Keep in mind, returns are based on CD performance. There is no annual percentage yield or periodic rate of interest on this index CD. Don't miss out. Take advantage of this financial resource designed to grow with the times. The October 13th funding deadline will be here before you know it. So hurry over to everbank.com/TFNN for the CD's term sheet and other important product details and disclosures. Once again, that's everbank.com/TFNN. This advertisement is sponsored content. EverBank is a member FDIC.
It's 2016, and TFNN has a brand new programming lineup to kick things off. Starting January 4th, Swim Lessons by Thinkorswim and TD Ameritrade will be airing 5 days a week at noon Eastern Time. Join hosts Scott Connor, Kevin Hinks, and Cindy Faber as they host their daily options program live at noon 5 days a week with no commercials for the entire hour. Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark will be moving their program, Living a Primal Lifestyle, to twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 a.m. until 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Wake up with Nico and Paige and start your day off right. The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour by Nadex will now be live Mondays and Fridays at 10 a.m. Start and end the week with the three hosts, Tom O'Brien, Tommy O'Brien, and Daryl Martin, as they break down the world of trading binary options and spreads. For all the details on the new 2016 programming lineup, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Catch the Money Masters as they teach you the art of mastering money when it comes to trading and investing. Next on TFNN.
Okay, folks, we just hit 1288 in the gold. Whether that's going to hold it or not, I'm not sure, but it's going to be somewhere between 1288 and 1282. We're down 25 bucks an ounce, which is quite a bit considering there's not a whole lot of news out there. And this is, very unusual in itself. There's another one that I wanted to bring to your attention because it's just doing totally the opposite, and they usually have a very high correlation between the two, and that is the crude oil market. If we take a look at crude here over the past several months, you'll notice the you'll be looking at this 1.618 expansion that we're having here. It's also a 1.27 butterfly pattern from way back on September the 8th. Now, this just means that there's a great deal of resistance supposedly at $49 per barrel. That's just what that is, supposed. So this is not a recommendation to sell the crude oil, but if you're interested on the short side, what you should do is wait a bar or two, and I don't mean standing at the bar. I mean wait for a bar or candle, to finish up so that you're not trying to pick, an absolute high because you don't have to be a you don't have to try to catch a falling safe, and that's what you'd be doing here in gold and also in silver. You have to wait to see that you're going to get some type of a reversal pattern. These have completed, so we'll see what is looking at. Now, someone's asked a question about the euro, and that was very clear to me about the euro, that the euro has a great deal of support right where we're trading right now. At this 111.60 area, below 111.20, it's just has no support at all. That relates back to that U.S. dollar index chart. Going above 96.50 would be a pretty good breakout to the upside, but it's still early in the day. So that's what you just don't know when these patterns are going to fail, folks. They're nothing more than numbers, what we're watching when we're looking at these things. That's really all they are. Now, sometimes they work better than others, but they're applicable enough that you should pay attention to them. That's basically the bottom line. Right now, our low in the euro's been 111.50. We've hit that level several times over the past several hours, so it does have a small amount of support in this area, but that's the main thing. What's interesting to watch right now is we've got gold trading at the 1288 level, and it's trading tick for tick. In other words, it's not going from 1288 to 1287. It's trading 1288.50, 1288.60, 1288.50. So there's orders setting in there. I mean, it's not just, you know, there's new shorts probably coming into the market, and there's probably people, you know, covering shorts, but it's not a cascading market to the downside like what we had between 1311 and 1299. That was basically straight down, nothing but powerful selling, you know, dropping 50 cents to a dollar at a time. That's not what's happening in the gold market, right? Whoops, maybe it is. It just dropped a dollar. Well, they must be listening to me there on the old Comex floor there in Chicago, so we'll see. Anyway, that's what it looked like to me, but we're now below the 1288 level, and so the 786, of course, is 1282, and silver is breaking down below, so there's no sense trying to try to find a bottom in it right now. The easiest way to look at it is, you know, wait a half hour to an hour, and you'll have a nice little pattern, either an ABCD, the upside, to get short, or a Gartley pattern to get by, to get a buy. But there's no sense trying to, to pick a bottom in these markets. When we get to the stock market, as you can see, yesterday we did nothing more than make an
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of the Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a two-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your two-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.